Hey, everyone.
Disruption is a force.
All right, that's okay. We got plenty of voices to raise up here to worship our Lord. Beautiful sunshiny day here. Of course, that's all reflecting off that fresh snow. Ah, well, it is only February. But this Wednesday does two things. It's the first day of March, and it's also Ash Wednesday. Yep, here we go. So we're going to be starting our Lenten services this Wednesday at 7:15 p.m. We'll be doing the Holden Prayer Service. Now before we have the service, we're going to do a little bit of fellowship and a potluck dinner. So at 5:30, we'll be having dinner here downstairs. And if you'd like to bring something along to share one of your goodies or delicacies, sign up downstairs and bring it on Wednesday. The dinner will be at 5:30, service at 7:15. Then the following Wednesdays after that, our services will be at 17. We won't have a dinner except for the last Wednesday before Passion Week. I know it's getting confusing now at this point, but I'll repeating it as the weeks go on. April 5th, then we will have one more potluck dinner, and there's a sign up downstairs for that as well. We'll have a Lenten round robin, a number of different pastors coming in besides myself, so you'll be able to hear the Word of God preached from a number of different angles. And it's going to be, you got some good preachers coming, so as long as you allow me to still come back, it's all good. Starting this Wednesday, Ash Wednesday service. There's going to be on our Bible studies on Tuesdays. We're going to be taking a break. It's because a number of our congregation people have flown the coop. These snowbirds have gone south to warmer climes, and therefore we're not going to be having our Tuesday Bible study until it resumes again on April 18th after Easter. So let's take a break, do your devotions, or better yet, come on Wednesday evening for our Lenten worship services. Okay, our last announcement is... Nope, not for Chinese takeout. However, Mary Ann's going to come up and bring you the good news, the great news of what we're doing with these boxes. Take it away, Todd.
You all remember when we were kids, like around, was it Christmas, Easter time? We had the quarter folders, and we stuck a quarter in there, and we turned it in. I think it was Easter, wasn't it? We're trying to do something kind of along those lines. Those quarters kind of represented your thankfulness for something or whatever it was at that time. And an idea was approved by the council the other night that we're going to start something similar to that. And what it is that each of you will get a box. And as you are thankful for something, throw a quarter, throw a nickel, a dime, dollar even.
Yeah.
They're kind of flimsy, so dollars would probably be better on a box than a load of coin. But either way, showing your thankfulness for something, put it in the box. We've got the larger box, we've got a smaller box. Maybe for the children, if they like a smaller box, or if you feel you'd rather have a smaller box, doesn't matter. Put your money in there, and whatever the month has a fifth Sunday in it, bring the box in. We'll throw it into a big old bag, take the bag to the bank, have them count it, and all the funds is going to go into our general operations fund. We felt we needed a little extra boost in that account. I feel we need a little extra boost in that account because it gets scary from month to month sometimes. We've got April, July, October, and December left this year where they have five Sundays. So when you leave, grab a box. You have a choice of colors too if you'd like. Grab a box, put your coin in it, and bring it back. The next time would be April 30th. And we'll see how we do with that. We're going to try that for this year. And like I said, it's all going to go into our general operations fund. Okay? Thank you.
Good. Great idea. And one of the things that you can do that make a difference, I know you don't seem to think that the change makes much of a difference, but it really does add up. One of the things that Mary Ann has brought up a while back was that if everybody gave one extra dollar a week, by the end of the year, the amazing difference it would make. So I'm saying, if you got a buck in your pocket, use that as a seed money for that box, whatever you have. And at the end of the week, just go ahead and open up the wallet, the purse, whatever, take out one buck, put it in there, And then whatever change you might have, put that in there as well. And you know, limit it to that box size, and you can always pour it into a bigger box and refill it again, too, if you want. Mark, what do you
got? Where the box is going to be?
Good question. Our divine ushers back there happen to have a box full of boxes back there, and you can choose your color as you exit. You want to model some of those there, Jack? Oh, look at those party colors. If you get the green one, that means you got to put extra green in there. Just kidding. All right, I think we're ready to go to worship our Lord. Our opening hymn is, O God, our help in ages past. This one will be out of the green hymnal, number 320. Please rise as you are able. Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Please be seated.
To the Israelites at the foot of the mountain, the glory of the Lord appeared
at the summit like a consuming fire. Then Moses disappeared into the cloud as he climbed higher up the mountain. He remained on the mountain 40 days and 40 nights. Our psalm today is Psalm 2, verses 7 through 12. Please join me on the even verses. Let me announce the decree of the Lord, he said to me. You are my son. This day I have begotten you.
Ask of me, and I will give you the nations for your inheritance, and the ends of the earth for your possessions.
You shall crush them with an iron rod and shatter them like a piece of pottery.
And now, you kings, be wise. Be warned, you rulers of the earth.
Submit to the Lord with fear, and with trembling bow before him.
Lest he be angry and you perish, for his wrath is quickly kindled.
Our second lesson then is taken from 2 Peter 1, verses 16 through 21. For we were not making up clever stories when we told you about the powerful coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. We saw his majestic splendor with our own eyes when he received honor and glory from God the Father. The voice from the majestic glory of God said to him, "This is my dearly beloved Son, who brings me great joy." We ourselves heard that voice from heaven when we were with him on the holy mountain. Because of that experience, we have even greater confidence in the message proclaimed by the prophets. You must pay close attention to what they wrote, for their words are like a lamp shining in a dark place until the day dawns and Christ, the morning star, shines in your hearts. Above all, you must realize that no prophecy in Scripture ever came from the prophet's own understanding or from human initiative. No, these prophets were moved by the Holy Spirit and they spoke from God. This ends the second lesson. Please rise as you're able for the reading of the gospel.
And his clothes became as white as light. Suddenly, Moses and Elijah appeared and began talking with Jesus. Peter exclaimed, "Lord, it's wonderful for us to be here. If you want, I'll make three shelters as memorials, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." But even as he spoke, a bright cloud overshadowed them, and a voice from the cloud said, "This is my dearly loved son, who brings me great joy. Listen to him." The disciples were terrified and fell face down on the ground. Then Jesus came over and touched them. "Get up," he said. "Don't be afraid." And when they looked up, Moses and Elijah were gone, and they saw only Jesus. As they went back down the mountain, Jesus commanded them, "Don't tell anyone what you have seen until the Son of Man has been raised from the dead." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated. This Sunday today marks a time of transition in the liturgical calendar of the church year. This is actually officially the last Sunday of the Epiphany season. And the purpose of the Epiphany season focuses on revealing who Jesus really is. From being an innocent baby born in a manger on Christmas, through to his manifestation and affirmation that he truly is the Son of God at the Transfiguration. During the Epiphany season, we saw Jesus as the healer, the preacher,
and the fulfiller of the law, as he called each of his disciples to follow him. The transfiguration marks the final revelation of the baby born in the manger, and we see Jesus revealed as he hasn't been revealed before. For it is through this event that we see what Jesus had been proclaiming about what he said about himself. And we see Jesus in all his glory, and we see his divine nature as the true Son of God. Our gospel text for today describes the transfiguration of Jesus in verse 2. As the men watched, Jesus' appearance was transformed so that his face shone like the sun and his clothes became white as light. Now, this event was much more than just a visual sign of God's power. It was the actual divinity of Jesus shining through his humanity that the disciples saw. So by reading about this event in the Bible, this gives us an assurance that Jesus is the Son of God, and that everything he had proclaimed about himself was indeed true. As we end the season of Epiphany, now we begin the season of Lent, which starts with our Ash Wednesday service this week. So we begin our Lenten pilgrimage with the assurance that we are indeed following the Son of God. Not any kind of an imposter or a pretender, but the true Son of God who is revealed through this mountaintop experience. But before we dig in our gospel text on this whole transfiguration thing, I'd like for us to take a look at about the context of what the transfiguration was all about. And in order to do that, we need to go way back in the Old Testament, way back to the book of Exodus, when Moses had led the Hebrews out of Egypt. In chapter 34, Moses went up to the mountain to obtain the law of God. And when he came back down, verse 35 says that Moses' face was so radiant that he had to cover it so that people couldn't even look at him. Being in the presence of God had caused Moses' face to actually shine with a reflection of the glory of God. And the whole purpose of Moses reflecting the glory of God was so that the Israelites could see and know that Moses had the blessing of God and therefore had the authority to represent the Almighty God to his people. In our gospel text for today, verse 2 also states that Jesus' face shone like the sun. However, for Jesus, he didn't just reflect the glory of God. Jesus is the glory of God. And verse 2 tells us that Jesus was transformed right in front of the disciples. Now, this word transformed comes from the Greek word metamorpho, which means to transfigure and transform. An example of this is in the form we use today of the term we use today of metamorphosis, which happens when a caterpillar inside a cocoon becomes transformed and transfigured into a beautiful butterfly. At the transfiguration, the deity of Jesus that was on the inside of himself had for just a few moments transfigured, and the glory of God had then appeared on the outside of his body. Now, the transfiguration didn't just happen so as to be a razzle-dazzle event. There was a definite purpose to the transfiguration of Jesus, because it was through this metamorphosis of Jesus
that God spoke words of confirmation to the disciples who were witnessing the event. After seeing the glory of God revealed through Jesus, God himself proclaims in verse 5, "This is my dearly loved Son, who brings me great joy." And after God says this, he gives the disciples just one command. Listen to him. Isn't it interesting that the command from God wasn't tell everyone what you saw? In fact, Jesus even says later in verse 9, don't tell anyone what you have seen until the Son of Man has been raised from the dead. The only command given by God is, listen to him. So simple, yet so profound and powerful within its meaning. Think of how the world's problems would be solved if everyone would just listen to Jesus. So, how do we listen to Jesus today? First, we can hear Jesus by reading and studying God's Word. But there's a whole lot more to what God is commanding. Our Almighty Father in heaven didn't say to just hear his Son. God commanded the disciples, which includes us, to listen to Jesus. Now this word listen comes from the Greek word akouo, which means to listen attentively and comprehend. God wants us to completely open our ears, our minds, and our hearts to everything that he wants to tell us through his Son Jesus. And that's where we will hear the voice of God. You don't need to wait for some special revelation or something spoken in a dream to see and know what God's will is for your life. Just open up his holy word, his living word, and let the Holy Spirit work through you to help you understand and then apply those truths to your life. And you know what will happen then? God will then transfigure you. He's going to transfigure you on the inside so that you will also be able to reflect the light of Jesus into the darkness of the world which surrounds us. Second book of Corinthians, chapter 3, verse 18, gives us this promise. So all of us who have had that veil removed can see and reflect the glory of the Lord. And the Lord, who is the Spirit, makes us more and more like him as we are changed into his glorious image. But before that metamorphosis can happen in our lives, we absolutely have to first obey that command from God, and that is, listen to him. And when you read the Bible and let its truth soak into your mind and your heart and your spirit, through his Holy Spirit, God will transfigure you on the inside so that you too can reflect the glory of God on the outside. Now, that word listen, for all you grammar scholars out there, is actually grammatically called a verb. And if you remember from your grammar lessons in school, what is a verb? It's an action word. Our Almighty God isn't saying, allow the sound waves of my Son's voice to penetrate your ears so that your brain can process those waves into words you can understand. No. God is saying, God is commanding.
commanding that we listen to him and then do what he says.
I ain't done yet. I got it. James. Chuck, you knew I was going to James. I bet you did. James chapter 1, verses 22 through 25 confirms this truth with the words, but don't just listen to God's word. You must do what it says. Otherwise, you are only fooling yourselves. For if you listen to the word and don't obey, it is like glancing at your face in a mirror. You see yourself, walk away, and forget what you look like. But if you look carefully into the perfect law that sets you free, and if you do what it says and don't forget what you heard, then God will bless you for doing it. So friends, for this Lenten season, let's commit ourselves intentionally to that command from God and listen to him. And after we have listened attentively and comprehended those truths that have been revealed to us through the scriptures, we then need to apply those truths directly into our everyday lives. God says, listen to him. And then, if you've listened, let God transfigure you from the inside so that you can reflect his glory to the people in your community, your county, your country, and to the continents. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you for the gift of your Son who so perfectly represents your will for us to this world. On that day when you revealed your glory through your one and only Son, you were giving us a promise that through your holy word, we too can be transfigured to reflect the glory of you to this very dark world. Father God, help us to become closer to you through studying your holy word and listening to all that you have to say to us through your holy word. Bring your Holy Spirit to open our minds, our hearts, and our spirits to those truths which will change us into the holy people that you want us to be. And we pray this in the holy name of your Son, Jesus. Amen. Our next hymn is Great is Thy Faithfulness. We do a hymnal switch here. We're working on the blue one for this number 775. Thank you.
let us all proclaim together the words of our Christian faith.
I believe in God, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus, and for all people according to their needs. Lord God, as we move into this Lent season, starting this Wednesday, reminding us that we are ashes, and to dust we shall return. Lord, put our promises within you and your Son Jesus. Lord, as this Lenten season starts again, once again, Lord, help us. Help us to proclaim that truth that is within your Son Jesus. Lord, in your mercy.
Your prayer.
Father God, we pray for a number of people who are on our hearts in need of your healing touch. Lord, we pray especially for the Bailey family at this time and the Shoemaker family as they mourn the death of Dave's father. Lord, it's been a tough couple weeks for them. So Lord, we pray for your mercy and your strength and peace. Lord, we pray for all those who are mourning loved ones who've been lost in the last months or even years. Lord, they hurt, Lord. And so we pray for your peace and strength to touch all of those. And also all of those people who are in need of your healing touch in their bodies, as well as their spirit at this time. Lord, I'll send you Jehovah Rapha down to all those people on our minds and hearts at this time. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Father God, we pray for a healing of this nation. As a congregation, we promise to pray for this nation and pray for its nation's leaders, that they make decisions in accordance to your will and not their own agenda. Lord, we pray for their protection, pray for their safety, Lord. And we promise to continue to pray for this nation to turn back to you. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord God, we pray for all those soldiers who are fighting for the freedoms of this nation. Protect them, Lord. Keep them safe. Father God, bring them home. Reunite them with their families. Help us as a nation to stand by them as they stood by for us and transition back into society with jobs and healing also for their bodies and for their minds and spirits. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord God, we pray for all those people that we know, family and friends, and then also, Lord, as a community, people that we support that are out on those highways and in our community serving us, law enforcement personnel, fire department personnel, first responders, ambulance drivers, Lord. Protect them. Keep them safe. Help us as a community to support them and help them do the job that they need to do. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Father God, we pray for all those missionaries that we support individually and as a congregation. Protect them, Lord. Keep them safe. Protect them from any kind of human evil and the evil of Satan. Protect their health, Lord, and the health of their families. And Lord God, please provide them with the resources that they need to do those ministries you've called them to. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
If there's anyone who has any prayers that they'd like to make at this time, please go ahead and say them. And to your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray. Trusting in the mercy of your Son, Jesus, amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Please share the peace of God with one another.
Thank you.
Father, we offer
with joy and thanksgiving what you have first given us, ourselves, our time, and our possessions, signs of your gracious love. Receive them for the sake of him who offered himself for us, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Okay, being this is the last Sunday of the month, please rise as you are able. We are going to be singing the Lord's Prayer. Now go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Amen.
Thanks be to God.
Do it.